for joining.
I would like to thank you for the invitation. It's a very good pleasure for us, you know, to present us the work that we have done as a public authority, you know, to support all the efforts that are made from public sector and also from the private sector. I would like to say that it's an opportunity for us that we are coordinators of 10T financing instruments, and also that we are coordinators of the SEF instruments, and we are representing the country in the SEF coordination meeting. Also, I would like to say that I'm very glad that we have very good colleagues in our team, and with their support, we have succeeded a lot of things that we would like to present you, because I believe that we have made quite a successful work in order to succeed a lot of the things that we have succeeded up to now. I'll try to be as not very detailed, although that I have made a lot of presentations. How does work this, please? Oh, okay. Actually, as we can start, the Trans-European Network has started in the 80s in conjunction with a single European market, and thus has the aspect of financing transport, energy, and also telecommunication projects. Transport network does finance all the kind of sectors, railroad, seaports, etc. And actually, the beginning of the 10T financial policy has the main priority to finance priority sectors and also to finance different sectors, rails, ITC projects, etc. Sorry. I would like to make a just small review for what we have succeeded. As in the previous periods, 1994, 1999, 2000, 2006, and 2007, 2013, we have actually have the 10T budget, which a private it was a European line that did finance the projects in Greece, and especially it does finance projects in a state of study. And then these studies be financed as a project by the Cohesion Fund, ERDF, State Budget, European Investment Bank, and PPP. In the first programming period, we have financed 65 actions with a budget of 325 million euros. In the programming period, 2006, we have financed 14 actions with 92 million euros. In the different sectors of 10T. In the period of 2007-2013, we have financed 27 actions of 80 million euros. And that was projects that that was studies that led to projects that we financed through Cohesion Fund and ERDF. So actually what we did, what we did, we used this 10T budget as a pioneer instrument in order to prepare studies, to prepare projects to be financed after that through Cohesion Fund, through ERDF, and also through PPPs. And we have a very large and very significant projects that they have been financed. This is the map, the previous map, of a 10T network. You can see the scarcity of the map. And before and after that, you can see the difference that now does exist. According to the previous 10T network, we have three actually main priority axes. What it was the most. One, it was the rail axis of 22 that connects Greece with Central Europe, and also we can see the axis of PP7, that it's a road axis that connects again Greece with Central Europe. You can see it in the map. Concerning the most projects. We have made, and we were coordinators in a study of East Med MOS project as Greek authorities, and also we are leaders in a study that is C2C that connects Greece with Bulgarian borders. Also, we have participated in many significant projects like Adriamos, Mona Lisa, Anna, etc. So we had for ASCOS and the MOS participation either as leaders or either as participants in a number of MOS projects that they did give us a lot of experience on how to proceed further. Just a small, it's very substantial to say that this the interconnection of MOS with rail and road sector, you can see the map. We have applied two studies. We have studied all the axes, the PP7 and PP22, and that studies have completed. PPP is going to get completed, so we know exactly all the axes, and we know where that the problems that that do exist. As an outcome of this period of 1994 to 2013, we have, as we have said, all the studies that we did finance in order to be prepared. And following that, we have completed different sections of projects. For example, we have completed Egnatia Odos, we have completed Attiki Odos, which is the ring road of Athens, and we have completed parts of Pathé. Also, we have financed different parts of Pathé, which is the rail axis of Greece, starting from Patras and heading up to Thessaloniki and to Greek, to the Greek-Bulgarian, Greek borders with the Phirom. And also, we have financed a number of ports, Igoumenitsa, Piraeus, Patra and Thessaloniki. Also, different studies that do complement the connections between them. As an outcome of this period, it's that the experience that we have gained through cooperations with our member states, either as leaders or as participants, in these studies we were the leaders, that gave us very big opportunity and the advantage that we could support all the efforts that made from the Commission in order to revise the TEN-T network and to come to what exists now, which is the SEF network. That one that we see in the picture. So from a scarcity that we had in the previous map of TEN-T network, now we have come to a more sustained network, which in a general has a corridor approach. That is very, very important, and we know how we stand and what we have to succeed. Concerning the TEN-T, it is expanding in three levels. We have the complementary, we have the comprehensive network, sorry, the core network, and we have the corridors. The budget that we have, it's for the, it's a 30 billion euros for SEF. The biggest part is for TEN-T, it's for transport, and we have biggest smaller parts for energy and for telecommunications. Out of 10T budget for transport, one very big part is for the cohesion fund and for the 14 member states. So here we see the 9 corridors plus the MOS corridor. It's very consistent, it's a different planning, so we can see that everybody knows better where to concentrate the efforts and also the financing. This is another. This is a table with the 9 corridors and member states that they do participate in each corridor. As a corridors, the main difference is that we have on the corridor a coordinator, which is very substantial, and also we have an administrative structure that leads to a corridor development plan. So under this procedure, all member states know what which is the plan, how they can invest and how they can concentrate all these efforts. In addition to that, we have the horizontal priorities that you can see. One of them is also MOS. And I would like now to concentrate that, on a project financing that we have made for the 10T projects in the current programming period, 2014-2020. We have CEF, with a big part comes to the Cohesion Fund member states for 10T. We have the structural funds that do finance 10T projects, and also we have state budget, European Investment Bank, and also PPPs. I think the big effort now is moving from grants to the different financial instruments. It's an effort that we do at this level. We are very successful, if I could say, in acquiring grants, but we are doing the first steps in order to utilize financial instruments that are very important for us. We have made a lot of contacts with EIB and also with DigiMove and with INEA, and we're in close contact on how we shall exploit better financial instruments. Concerning the financing of 10T projects in Greece for this programming period, first of all, there is a strategic framework of investments that applies up to 2025. There is an OP of accessibility that does connect the funds from structural funds and from CEF, and it describes in detail the process that are going to be financed in this OP in order to have complementary funds. So, again, it's a new priority that we do have to have a complementary funds. So we know what we're going to finance from CEF and what we're going to finance through the structural funds. Here we can see the different rates of financing that do exist concerning CEF in studies, in works, and also in telecommunication studies. And for cohesion fund, the rates of financing are different, are quite higher, and are up to 85%. And this does exist only for the 14 member states. At the national level, as we have said, I think it's we are the coordination authority. All the proposals and all the organization of submit proposals are coming through us, and also we have the final if I could say a final we are responsible against the European Commission for the implementation of the studies and of the works. It would be very very significant to refer of the submissions on the CEF call for proposals that we did this year. We have submitted a very large number of projects. We have submitted 15 projects with a budget of 832 million euros, and we have an approval of 9 projects with a budget of 800 million. So it was a very good success from our country to submit 15 proposals with 838 million and get an approval for 9 projects with 800 million. The most significant of that, it was the 2 projects that we did submitted for the cohesion envelope. And that cohesion envelope, that we do have a quota as a member state of 580 million, we did manage to acquire the 500 million. So it was a very big success for our country, and that was based on the preparation that we have with the managing authorities and with other colleagues in order to succeed that. Because it's very crucial to succeed that, this quota, and also because there is an intermediate evaluation up to 2017, there might be a possibility of getting or giving back some of the quota that now it's been acquired. So it needs a lot of effort to safeguard these 500 million. Our purpose is, in this call of in the beginning of 2016, to safeguard 80 million euros plus, and also there's an effort still to prepare and to mature in a number of different other projects that are going to be submitted at a later stage to a different calls to the European Commission. So I would say that it's a very good effort, and one of the approved projects, it is also Poseidon Med. For the projects that we have, it is approved. The last week, last Thursday, we did also sign the contracts with the DG Move. So these projects actually are on the run, and also we can acquire the fundings for these projects. Also, I would like to refer that we have also approvals from CEF for projects for CEF Energy, and we have also approved projects under the CEF calls for telecoms. Just a very, very small view on the core networks concerning ports. You can see it here. We have different ports in different phases. Other are completed, either are under financing, and I think there are some projects still to be financed under this programming period. So Igoumenitsa, Patra, Piraeus, they have been financed, and some parts they have been completed, and we still do finance in some of the projects. We can see some photos here. As concerning the core network for railways, the main part of the corridor is the rail from Patras to Thessaloniki. The part from Athens to Thessaloniki, one of the projects, the biggest one, it is financed by CEF, and it's one of the agreements that we did finance now, is the Thessalonikos-Dimokos. And there is another part from Patras to Thessaloniki, again financed through CEF, which is the part from Psathopyrgos to Rio. Again, we have completed different parts. One of the most important is the connection that we have managed to do from the port of Piraeus to Thriasio Pedio. This is the part Pythorelian Kleidomokos. And this is the part that it is financed under CEF. It's a small part from Psathopyrgos to Rio that it does finance from CEF too. We do hope that this financing and this is going to be completed by 2020, by the ending of this programming period of NSRF. So the main parts of OEM corridor that we do belong, which is Orient-East-Med corridor, is going to be completed by 2020. As concerning rail and roads, we do expect that we are going to be interconnected through Bulgaria, Romania, to the European Union, to the Central Europe, and is an effort that we do with the European coordinator, and according to the study that has been gained through this coordinator. So our effort is to complete our parts with the financing through CEF and through NSRF, and also to have also finance from other member states of the part of the main corridors in order to be connected with the European Union. Also, we try to complete and upgrade the main ports that are in the final stage, but still a lot of work has to be done. And also, we have to interconnect. There are some missing points to connect ports with the corridors. Again, we have another target to complete the Thriasio Pedio Freight Center, and also we study Thessaloniki Freight Port and also Igoumenitsa Freight Port in order to have again in these ports to have freight centers. Our effort is to remove any bottlenecks connecting ports with the main corridors. Financing, I think the financing that we have safeguarded through NSRF and through CEF. We have, as I mentioned before, financing through CEF by safeguarding this 500 million. We do expect and we do support and we shall submit proposals in order to gain the rest 80 million from our quota. And also, we are planning through the multi-annual and annual programs to get any support that we can in order to prepare, submit, and have some different financing outside from the cohesion fund. Also, we would like to strengthen our cooperation with the different member states. We have done it with Malta, with Cyprus, with Italy, with Bulgaria, with Romania. So we would like to envisage in new cooperations with a new in a new projects. Also, we have very good cooperation with a coordinator of the Orient East Med Corridor. So, by new transport policy, I think it's quite important for us that the Trans-European network is going to be completed, and that one is going to give us a quite importance in new jobs, in economic, environmental, and social competitiveness, either of EU, either of European Union, of Greece. I would like to thank you for the invitation, and we are open in the new calls to receive your proposals and to be able to submit it and have successful proposals for SEF. Thanks a lot.